Charlie.
And thanks everyone for the presents, for the 6-pack of discount cola.
It's way sweeter than the ordinary stuff.
And the teen vampire film.
I'm dying to see it. Part one was brilliant.
And Louis's picture. And my vase.
Is that your main present? Taking your mum out for dinner.
A new Italian, Amici's. It's supposed to be really good.
Really good cake.
Oh, a little bit of the sitter.
Now you're all to be good, Charlie.
Of course I will. We'll play quietly, maybe a game of Scrabble?
Really? Oh, I'd love that. Carol!
You two know each other?
She's... Carol's the babysitter. She's 14. She's in my class.
Outstanding.
14? Does seem a bit young. Mm.
If you'd like to get a telephone reference, here's a list of my clients.
Oh, Dr. Gilchrist, the Ericsons. She's that lawyer, yeah, with the beautiful
teeth. Mum! I think Carol would be a brilliant babysitter. I'd feel really safe with her.
You shut up!
Hannah, you shouldn't speak to your brother like that.
Oh. So, Louis goes up by 8, Charlie at 9, and Hannah?
She'll take care of herself.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Bye.
Wouldn't sit there if I were you. We had a really old lady staying last week and, well, she weed on it. Yes. Come on, Charlie.
But I thought, aren't we playing Scrabble?
No.
We're doing night combat. That's why he's blindfolded.
We have to run around the whole room on the furniture without touching the floor. And Alison tries to hit us
with this. Ben, you're next.
Sorry!
Is this a good idea?
Go! Go! Okay. Small steps as far as you can go. Okay, be careful.
Wow!
Steady.
Do the biggest leap you can, Charlie. Go for it!
First day ever!
Okay, remember, safety comes first.
Shut up, Ben!
We were engaged in a combat op. You were back up.
But I... Ow!
There's no I in Special Forces Unit.
Actually, there's two. S, P, E...
It's okay. We can fix it.
Sorry, guys. Have to pull out. Curfew at 1900.
Oh, how convenient. You cause all this with your insane game, but when the trouble starts...
Are you questioning my loyalty?
Absolutely not. Please don't hurt me.
That's what I thought.
Hi, Hannah. You want some juice or a nice banana sandwich?
Get a life, loser.
On this week's Dingbat Crazy, a high-speed...
I'm not sure that's suitable.
A pool party in a public...
Hannah! I hope we're not going to have any trouble. I don't want to have to tell everyone at school you're a very naughty girl. You better not.
Now stop being silly and give me the remote.
Gardening. There. That's better.
Hello. Hey, table for two, please, and right.
Something by the window would be nice.
Yes, yeah, lovely.
Not here. Sorry, we're full.
No, I definitely booked. I spoke to a woman.
A woman? Nah.
No, I booked. I thought this table was empty.
Not empty, reserved.
Okay. See that table there, Missy? We're sitting there. End of story.
Barry?
I balked, I definitely balked.
How do they say this in Italian? Fiasco. Yeah, nice one.
It's probably best just to own up.
What? I'll get the blame.
What you did?
Shh. It's them, quick, twist it round so they can't see the broken bit.
We'll never fix that now.
You idiot!
And the kids are okay?
Good as gold. Well, took a while to get Hannah settled.
she's at that age.
Yeah, really annoying about the reservation. It must have been so disappointing for your wife.
Yes. She's upstairs having a bit of a lie down. Anyway. There we go.
Oh, no, please. £5 is fine.
No, we said 20.
Yes, but you're back so early.
Thank you, Carol. That's very good of you. We'll definitely use you again. Is that noise?
Careful.
Hang on. Yep.
Good night, Carol.
Quick!
Okay, boys?
Just chatting about jobs when we grow up. Ben wants to be an architect.
I like, buildings.
Okay, well, come on. You know, Mum don't like you being in here. Come on.
We'll go up tomorrow and maybe a game of Scrabble.
Ah, Scrabble fan, eh?
Caught up in this now. Your mum will see. She'll tell my mum.
Forget all that. Look what I found at the bottom of the vase.
Thompson's? So?
That's where Dad bought it. We'll go down there, get a new one.
28 quid? Where are we going to get that kind of money?
We tried to stop you, but we couldn't. Look. You broke Mum's vase. I think you were having a dream.
Cries for all the world.
That's right. He was making a squawking noise, wasn't he, Ben?
Yeah.
And then he just ran at the vase, flapping your arms, and smashed it. Didn't he, Ben?
Yeah.
Gonna be awful when Mum finds out. She loved that vase.
Will I be in trouble?
Yeah. She'll probably send you to boarding school.
Oh.
We better go up and get your bags packed. Unless... You got any money in your piggy bank?
£32.44.
I've got an idea. I could go to the shop, buy a new vase before Mum finds out. That way she'll never know and you won't be in any trouble at all. What do you think?
Thanks, Charlie. This is a low point, even for us.
Oh dear. Terrible. Poor chap went in the sea after his dog drowned. Death certainly puts our little problems into perspective, doesn't it?
Well, that's a good thing about death, isn't it? It just sort of happens. You don't have to book for it.
Mum, when you sleepwalk, could you go into the road and be run over?
I don't know. Why are you worrying about sleepwalk?
Just something we saw in the telly. I told you it wasn't suitable, Ben.
I didn't.
Oh,
don't want any breakfast.
If this is about the babysitter, I'm not in the mood.
I can't stand it. I can't stand another minute.
Right. You can finish tidying up in here. I'm going to do the rooms, and then I'm going for a drive around the industrial estate for a bit of peace and quiet.
We'll help. Me and Ben, we can do all that dusting, vacuuming.
You've done something, haven't you? What have you done?
I just want to help. Because you're sad about Dad ruining your birthday.
Thanks, Charlie. See that? More feeling in his little finger than you'll ever have.
I booked! I booked! I did! I booked!
Bye, Mum. Have a nice time.
See you later.
Come on, we have to dump the old vase and get the new one before she gets back.
I'll just put this away.
Hurry up! Louis, the money. You still worried about sleepwalking into traffic? I thought what we could do about that. Every night after you go to sleep, I'll tie you to the bed with sticky tape, and in the morning, before you wake up, I'll take the tape off.
I don't like being sticky.
I'll get the special German tape, the one that don't leave any sticky on you at all.
Thanks, Charlie.
You can't be serious.
Think they'll let us pay in 2p.
We'll say we've been saving up for ages. They'll probably think it's cute. They like that sort of thing, grown-ups. There's the woman from the shop and she's got the vase.
Bigger job than I thought. Take about 3 days.
Oh, for goodness sake. Yes?
I'm afraid there's been a little bit of a mix-up. Mr. Thompson said he'd sold you a vase, but my mum had already paid a deposit on it.
Sorry, what?
Technically, my mum owns that vase.
I don't know who you are, but would you please go away?
It's for our dad's ashes. Probably saw it in the paper, did you? He jumped in the sea to save this dog.
The bloke who drowned?
Yeah.
You should be proud, son. Your dad's a legend. Hey, lads. That drowning dog bloke. These are his boys. Come on. Let's have a whip round, eh? Help with the flowers. Yeah.
Thanks. What, the vase? Our mum picked it out especially for Dad's ashes. Didn't she, Jim?
Yeah. Henry.
All right. All right, you can have it.
Let's see. 28 quid.
It's fine. You can give it to your mum. Say it's from me, Mrs. Shepherd. And I'm sorry for her loss.
Thanks. Kind. Just like our dad was.
Better get on.
dusty, thought I'd give it a polish. Came up well, didn't it?
What's got into you today?
Just you. Being sad. About Dad ruining your birthday.
Oh, well, you're not really upset about that, are you? Oh, listen. All mums and dads fight. It's no big deal, all right?
All right?
Yeah, sorry about this morning. The restaurant wasn't your fault.
Really?
Yeah, we'll go another time.
Okay. Well, tonight, then?
Yeah. All right, mister?
Okay. Yes? Well, listen. Okay, so listen. It's 7 o'clock, table for two, Enright. Right, and that is definitely confirmed for tonight. No, it's just that I need to let you know I am recording this conversation. And if there is a problem with this booking, I will be forced to take further steps. And you'll find I'm not a man to be trifled. Hello?
You're going out tonight?
Yes. Touch wood. Or whatever that is. Your mum's going to ring Carol. So please, for my sake, do not make a song and dance about it.
Okay, Dad.
Right.
Hello, is that Carol? Hello, Carol. Yes, this is Jane Burke, Dr. Burke's wife. Yes, we need a sitter for tonight and we've heard good things about you. Are you free? Excellent, excellent.
I gave Louis his money back and we've still got £40 left. Let's go down the arcade.
No, we can't just start throwing money around. We'll be caught.
I say we wait a month and then spend it carefully, little by little.
I'm going to buy a rat with my share.
Good idea. We could put Sparrow in with it, see what happens.
I'll take a wild guess.
I don't want it as a pet. I'm going to cook it and eat it. Practice for survival in the jungle.
What is wrong with you?
One step beyond!
You broke. There's a lady staying and she mustn't see it.
Why?
Because I got the new vase from it and I told a little lie. And anyway, I need you to go down and stand in front of it.
Why can't you stand in front of it?
I can't. It's really important the lady doesn't see me.
Why?
Because she's a witch and I stole the vase from her and if she sees it, she'll take it back.
She might put a spell on me.
No, you see this chimp? It's a magic chimp. As long as you hold it, you'll be safe, all right?
Yeah.
And you won't have to stand there long, because you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to get rid of the witch.
No, it's fine, Carol. I'm sure we'll find someone else. OK, bye. Carol's not free.
Mum, you know that lady who's staying, Mrs. Shepherd?
Yeah?
I heard in town she's a thief, steals TVs and laptops.
Don't be ridiculous.
Such an idiot.
It's true! They call her Mrs. Shepherd the thief. We should probably tell her to get lost. You know, she's probably here to steal our...
Quiet.
Although, Mrs. Shepherd, maybe she could babysit.
No! Let me do it. Please, Mum, I'll do a really good job. Just give me one chance.
Yeah, Mum, let Hannah do it. I promise I'll be good for her. Please.
Please, Mum. Okay. One chance.
Hello.
I've got serious problems.
Me too. A rich source of protein, I just couldn't do it.
It's Pattern. He's so cute.
Pattern?
I know. I shouldn't have named it.
Charlie! Mum and Dad are gone, and if you do anything, anything to mess this up for me, I'll turn your life into a living nightmare. I'm just sitting here quietly. I bet other kids don't have to put up with people charging in, threatening them. I bet!
Seriously, you have been warned.
Then, my mum found Pattern, went completely hysterical.
Typical civilian.
Yeah, women hate rats, don't they?
When Mrs. Shepherd sees Pattern, she'll run a mile. Who'd stay in a B&B that has rats?
Outstanding.
You haven't seen Louis, get down!
No!
Louis, I'm warning you.
You should stand on something too. She won't get bitten.
A rat!
Get away! Keep it away from me!
We had a plague of those in the garden. The important thing is, never let them escape.
You'll see the boy!
I need to pull Pattern out!
Give me 3 seconds!
Stop! What's going on? Someone's locked us in!
Not. Finally. Oh, it's from Hannah.
Oh.
I hope you're having a lovely evening. If police phone, don't worry, everything fine.
Can we get the bill, please?
There was no need for you to come. It was nothing.
Nothing? I was imprisoned.
She's a witch. She stole from Magic Bar.
Louis! Sorry, he's not normal.
So, someone locked you in?
That's what I'm telling you. I was held against my will.
It was my other brother, you see, because I climbed out the window and went around to let us out because he jammed a chair under the door handle.
What? Well, why would he... I knew I'd been here before. Your brother, is his name?
Charlie.
That went brilliant. Mrs. Shepherd must have been really upset if she phoned the police. I bet she's leaving.
Thanks for minding Pattern. Maybe if I don't see him for a few days, I might not like him as much. Then I'll be able to cook him.
Don't worry, I won't let her cook you. You're the best rat ever. Me and you
Charlie,
will...
Charlie, the police want you downstairs!
working so hard.
Mrs. Shepherd, wait.
Not for one second. Place is a madhouse.
What happened? What did you do?
It wasn't my fault. It was Charlie, you see. He locked us in a room with a rat.
You were in charge. Never again. You will have Carol babysit until you're 20.
But it was Charlie!
No!
You! The boy whose father drowned.
What?
Charlie!
It's okay, Mum. I caught the rat. Did I get a reward? Right, do all the dishes for a week. And for what? For trying to fix my mum's birthday present? What kind of lesson's that for a child? It's a travesty of justice!